I now invite Professor R. Narasimhan to share some of his experiences with Professor Simha.
Thank you, Sundi. I have a short presentation which I put together. So I'm going to share my screen. Are you able to see it?
Yes.
Okay, so this is about my association with Simha. So I joined the department in 1991, and for the record, we have taught ME242 solid mechanics together from 1991 to 2002, 12 years before Joke snatched away the course from us. And ME293 fracture mechanics, we have been teaching continuously from 1991 to 2020. It's almost 30 years we have been teaching this course together. In fact, I have all the final exam papers from 91 to 2020. I've collected it because Simha's questions are very unique. In fact, the problems are so creatively set, I don't have the solutions for them. I would ask Simha to give me the answers for many of those questions. And by the way, we also have Borgi's ME242 final exam paper, solution paper. And somehow Satish escaped us. He graduated before we got onto this job. Let me run through a flashback, a selected flashback with Simha. It's going to go backward in time. So let me say first about a meeting I organized in Coorg in 2018, Indo-US workshop. And I invited Simha to the conference. And Simha said, look, I can't give a talk, but if you give me any other role, I'll do it. Then I told Simha that why don't you chair the panel discussion and also a couple of sessions. And also, we have this new kid on the block, Ram. So you have to take care of him and make sure that he doesn't get into any trouble. So Simha said, no problem. You put me in the same cottage with Ram and I'll look after him. And that's precisely what happened. So Simha and Ram and later Tejas also joined the party. So they had a wonderful time for 4 days in the same cottage. And here are some pictures from the conference. So this is on the banks of the Kaveri. The Kaveri River runs very close to Orange County, where the conference was held. And here's a morning walk, which we took along with Simha. So Simha climbed down and he was threatening to get into the water. So he was looking back, asking us, myself, my wife, and a few others were there. And then he was looking at us quizzically. And then finally, he decided to take the plunge. So here I go. So he bent down and instead of jumping into the water, he just took a handful of it and then sprayed it on his head. This is another photograph of Simha along with my wife and Venkat Narayanan, IIT Kanpur, taken at the same place. You can see the Kaveri in the background. One more picture from the conference, and this is a group photograph, and you can see the entire gang here. And Simha right at the top of this gang over there, and next to him is Alan Nagelman. So I don't know what Alan Nagelman is looking at. He seems to have turned his head sideways looking at something. And the Swamiji over here is Sumit Basu, our former student. So this is a picture of the panel discussion which Simha chaired along with some of the other panelists. And Simha seems to be telling the audience, hey guys, listen to what I'm saying. Well, let me go back in time and recap an incident which happened probably in the mid-90s when a Caltech geophysicist, a very renowned geophysicist, Tom Arends, visited us. My advisor, Aristosakis, had written to me saying that Arends is a good friend and I want you to take care of him. So I said, no problem. And then I asked Simha, look, I'm a bit nervous. This guy is a well-known geophysicist. I don't want to offend him in any way. Then Simha said, no problem. We'll do it together. So we went to the airport, the old Bangalore airport, picked him up and then brought him to the guest house. And we wouldn't believe it. Tom Arends never stopped talking and he was talking about everything. He's actually a geophysicist who worked on planetary impact. So he was talking about the Schumacher-Levy and K2 boundary and all that sort of thing. In fact, he gave a talk in our department on the KT boundary, the Cretaceous Tertiary boundary. We took Tom Arends around the campus for one full day. And then towards the evening, I think probably around 3 o'clock, we took him to meet Rodham Narasimha. Rodham in those days used to be in the Nias. So we took him there and we spent something like about 3 hours. So we were just spectators, Simha and me. Arans and Rodham were reminiscing the good old days of Caltech, starting from way back Clark Millikan and Hans Liepmann and Feynman and so on. So we listened to all those anecdotes. And then around 5:30 or so, we dropped him back at the guest house. So just as we were leaving, Tom Arens turned around and asked us, where are you guys going? So we told Professor Arens, we have spent the whole day with you. Now we have to go back to the lab and do some work. And Professor Arens, he just remarked, oh, so you guys do some work over here. So this was the icing on the cake. And I remember Simha and me, we came back and we were laughing our head off the whole evening. And for many days after that, about this particular remark. Simha had some very nice names and ways of calling different people. So I just want to recall a few of them. We had a colleague called N. Raman, who used to work in the ICE engines area. And N actually stands for Narasimhan, his father's name. And his native place was Kumbakonam. For some unknown reason, Simha used to call him Namakkal Raman. And I don't really know why. Probably Simha himself can answer that question, why he used to call him Namakkal. And he used to address him always by that name. In fact, Simha, a few days back, Raman called me and wanted to talk to you. So I gave him your mobile number and asked him to first text you and then call you, because I know that you won't answer calls. And he told me that he texted you, but you're not picking it up. So please do answer Namakkal's call. The other guy who was popular in our circles, Australian Iyengar. This was K. Srinivasan, retired faculty. He actually took voluntary retirement and settled in Australia. And he used to come back once in a while. Yeah, even recently, he was here. So Simha used to call him Australian Iyengar because he is settled in Australia. And the third anecdote is about one was T.S. Ramamurthy. The first time when we started teaching fracture mechanics together, we wanted to find somebody who will teach fatigue. So Simha invited Professor T.S. Ramamurthy from aerospace, senior professor, to come and give us some lectures on fatigue. So the introduction which Professor Ramamurthy delivered went back to 1940s, and then he was talking about Elber and crack closure and so on. So at the end of the lecture, when we were together, Simha said, oh, this guy is Elber Ramamurthy. So from that time onwards, he used to call him Elber. There are a few facts in this slide, probably which many of you don't know. Simha had very other special talents. He was a super fast bowler. So in our cricket matches, which we used to have with students, Simha used to bowl so fast that students would never sight the ball at all. It's such a fast bowling that he used to do. And in fact, Simha captained the IISc cricket team for many years before Pradeep and others joined the IISc cricket team. Another one of Simha's talents is he's a foodie with an exquisite taste for the best food available. So he knows the best food joints from NKB to higher taste. So he's introduced me to a lot of food joints. So if you want to ask him what's the best place in Bangalore or dosa, for dosa or badam alwa, then we need to ask Simha, because he knows exactly what's the best place for all this. Let me now bid farewell to my solid mechanics brother. So buddy, we have had a long journey, 30 years together. Your station has come and you have to get off the train. Hopefully the department doesn't eject you from the platform. The department has never done that to anyone. But you, who knows, with the new rules, new administration, you don't know how things are going to head. But I sincerely hope you would still hang around in the platform. And by the way, my station is not too far off either. Hopefully we will retire and then we'll roam the streets of Bangalore freely looking for the best food joints. Best wishes, my solid mechanics brother, for a peaceful, happy, retired life. Thank you, Sonti, for giving me this chance.
Thank you, Professor Narasimhan.